Growing up, I had always heard that the first successful flight of a flying machine was in North Carolina. After all, the slogan on the North Carolina license plate is "First in Flight." To me, it was a given. In fact, I had always assumed, which I now embarrassingly admit to all of you, that the Wright brothers were from North Carolina. But this was before I knew practically anything about the Wright brothers or the arduous struggle to achieve flight. One of my earliest videos was about the Wright brothers and their fight for flight, as I called it. I quickly learned that Wilbur and Orville Wright were not from North Carolina, but from Ohio. Now, I had heard in passing the argument that it was actually Ohio, not North Carolina, which was the first to fly, but I dismissed these claims as little more than clickbait articles trying to collect ad revenue from enthusiasts like myself. As it turned out, there was an argument to be made for Ohio's being the first state in flight. Now, if you don't know much about the Wright brothers, you might be wondering how North Carolina had any claim at all, now that I've told you that they were from Ohio. Well, if I recall, and I would refer you to my original video on the Wright brothers for more detail, Wilbur and Orville Wright had consulted with the United States Weather Bureau to determine the best place to conduct tests for their experimental flying machine. And as it turned out, the Outer Banks of North Carolina were the best due to the speed, direction, and consistency of the wind. So the dedicated fraternal duo packed up their flying machine and made their way out to North Carolina, having never been there before and not knowing a soul who lived there. This is where the debate gets real. Wilbur and Orville Wright, despite being liked in their hometown of Dayton, Ohio, were more or less ridiculed for their dream of flight. But in North Carolina, they were quickly aided by the locals. They couldn't even reach their destination of Kill Devil Hills without crossing the Albemarle Sound in a leaky schooner, sailed by a sympathetic local. When the brothers landed in Kill Devil Hills, south of Kitty Hawk, they stayed with the unsuspecting local man, Bill Tate, and his family, who helped Wilbur and Orville get by while they spent multiple summers out in those desolate dunes, scratching and clawing toward their goal of flight. When other locals learned of what the Wrights were doing, they came out to see for themselves. Especially when there were rumors of success, the Wright brothers had many supportive and enthusiastic spectators who, whether they knew it or not, were watching history unfold. Wilbur and Orville saw a lot of ups and downs in their efforts out in Kitty Hawk, but ultimately they learned a lot, and when they were finally able to equip their flying machine with a makeshift engine, the need for ideal conditions was outweighed by the need to be able to experiment year-round rather than just in the summer. So their efforts moved from North Carolina back to their home in Dayton, Ohio. This way, they could work on flying while also maintaining their now-famous bicycle shop for a living. Back home, the brothers flew out of the nearby Huffman Prairie. Suddenly, the tone of their fellow Ohioans had changed. The zany Wright brothers had done it. They were flying. The Wright brothers were on their way up, figuratively and literally. Next up, they would be in Europe, then Washington, D.C., and then New York. They had the potential to be wealthy men, but, more importantly, they would inevitably be fossilized in history. The story of the Wright brothers goes much further, but this is all we need to know in order to answer the question at hand. Is it Ohio, where the Wright brothers were from, or North Carolina, where they first achieved flight, which has the claim to the title of first in flight? Here's what we know. Wilbur and Orville were born in Dayton, Ohio. They were raised in Ohio and educated in Ohio. They came up with the inspiration to attempt flight in Ohio. Yet, they received minimal support for their goal from their friends and neighbors in Ohio, until they had already achieved it. On the other hand, Wilbur and Orville traveled to Kitty Hawk, North Carolina, specifically for the favorable wind conditions in the area. They were met with the aid and support of the admittedly surprised locals of the region. The first successful flight occurred there from the sandy ground of Kill Devil Hills on December 17, 1903. But as soon as it was no longer a necessity to conduct the test there, the brothers returned to Ohio. So where does that leave us? Well, I think it's largely subjective, but I don't have any strong ties to either state, and in fact, I have a positive opinion of both Ohio and North Carolina, and they are more or less equidistant from my own home state. So I would argue that I'm about as impartial a judge in this case as one could get. I know that no matter which way I go, it will please some people and upset others. I haven't read much into the arguments that others have made, so that I can come to my own conclusion. But what little I have seen tells me that the drama is real over this issue. Alright, I'll cut to the chase. Here's my conclusion. Ohio was first in flight. Now hold on. Before you type out an angry comment, let me explain my reasoning. Wilbur and Orville Wright were both men of Ohio. They, like all of us to some extent, were a product of their environment. Their friends, their family, their neighborhood, and their community made them who they were. and they came up with their inspiration while living in Dayton, Ohio. As soon as they could, they returned to Dayton to finish their experimentation. And even when they were rich and famous, they both finished out their lives in their home of Dayton, Ohio. Now, as I mentioned, the Wrights received a lot of support from the folks in North Carolina, and frankly, a lot of ridicule from the folks in Ohio, at least until they had shown some success. But that doesn't change the fact that the men who were themselves the first in flight called Ohio their home. But this is all my opinion. What do you think? Let me know calmly in the comments section. And remember to check out the new items in the merch store and consider joining the Facebook group, where you can interact with other transportation enthusiasts. Thank you for watching.